Dear students, next toolbar of insert menu is about table. In this toolbar, we will learn how to insert table in the document. Before applying the command, first place the cursor where do you want to insert a table. For example, I'm going to insert a table after paragraph number 1. Apply the command tables, select how many rows and column do you want to insert in the document. So a table of 3 rows and 3 columns is inserted in this document. As I inserted a table, you can see that 2 menus are added in the menu bar. The first menu is design menu and the second one is layout. So design menu belongs to the design of the table. For example, I'm going to change the table style. So select the style which you want to apply. Selected style will be applied. Next command is shading. If you want to add a shade to your rows or columns, you can do this. For example, I'm going to change the shade of the first row of the table. So I will select the selected the row, and then I will select the shade which I want to apply. So this is how to change the shade of the rows of the cell. You can change a shade of a single cell by clicking the cursor in a cell and then apply the shade command. So the shade of the cell will be changed. So I'm going to press Ctrl Z because I don't want to change the shade of my cells. Next command is border style. So if you want to increase the size of the border, you can do this. For example, from here I will change. I'm going to select the border style. What should be the width of the line, and then what should be the pen color. And now I'm going to click the border. So the selected options will be applied to the border. Border painter is selected, and now click on this. So the selected styles are going to be applied in this. So this was the function of the border painter. I'm going to press Ctrl Z. Effect of this command will be removed. Next command in this toolbar is borders. So this is all about borders. If you don't want to keep the border, if you want to keep the border from the bottom of the cell, if you want to keep the top, if you want to keep the left border of the cell, if you want to keep right border of the cell, if you don't want to keep any border, so all borders. Next option is all border. So you can apply these options one by one. If you want to apply the border command to the whole table, so first select the table. Whole table will be selected, and then apply this command one by one. For example, I'm going to apply all borders. So this selected setting of the border will be applied to the whole table. This was all about borders. Next, I'm going to select the layout menu. Now I will tell you what toolbars are included in this menu. The first toolbar in this menu is table, and in table toolbar we have an option select. So what you can select? You can select a cell, you can select the complete row, and you can select a column through this command. For example, my cursor is in first cell and I'm going to select this cell. So select cell command will be applied, and the select only one cell will be selected. If you want to select the whole row, so go to the select command and then select row. So the complete row will be selected. If you want to select the complete column, so go to the select menu and then select command and then click on the select column. So complete column will be selected. If you want to select the complete table, go to the select command and then click an option select table. So complete table will be selected. Next is a view grid light command. This command, the effect of this command will not be see, will not be seen because I have already selected the borders. So if I want to see the effect of this command, first I will have to remove the borders of the table. So again I will go to the design menu, I will select the table, and then I will select no border. Now come to the layout menu and click on the view grid lines, so effect of this command can be seen on the screen. This was the effect of view grid line command. If you click on this, it will be disabled and no borders, no grid lines will be seen. If you want to click on this, grid lines will be appeared in the screen. Dear student, again I'm going to apply the borders, so I'm going to first I will select this table and then I will select the command all borders, so borders will be appeared. So now what is next in the table toolbar? Properties. Now I will discuss the properties of the table. Click on this. There are different properties. For example, first option is alignment of the table. By default, left alignment is selected. If you want to keep this table in center of the page, you select the center. But the effect of this command cannot be seen because the width of the table, size of the table is too long. Now I'm going to reduce the size and then select, going to the properties and select right. So you will see that the table will be shifted to the right side of the page. If you again click on the properties and you select the center, so the table will be shifted to the center of the page. Next command in this property is text wrapping. By default, text wrapping is disabled. If you want to wrap the text around the table, click the option around and click on OK button. So as you can see that now the text is wrapped around the table. Next toolbar in this menu is draw. In draw toolbar we have two options. The first one is draw table and the second one is eraser. Draw table command is used to add some other cells or rows in your table. For example, I want to draw a table. I want to add some other cells in the table. I will draw. So a cell is added. I'm going to add a new cell. So draw the cell. It will be added. If you draw another cell, it will be added in your document. Next command is eraser. This command is used to erase the border of the cells. Let's see what happened. Click on the erase and now click on this option. So the border is removed. So two cells are converted into a single cell. If I click on this border, so it will be removed and two cells will be converted into a single cell. If I click on this and this, so these cells are converted into a single cell. So this was the function of eraser. I'm going to press Ctrl Z command to bring the table in its original form. Next toolbar is rows and columns. In this toolbar we have different commands. For example, the first one is delete. What can you delete? You can delete a row, you can delete a column, you can delete a cell. Let's see what happened. If I select the first command, delete cells. After clicking on this, you will get another option, another menu where you have an option shift cell up, shift cell down, left, and delete entire cell. Let's say I want to delete the entire row, so I will select the delete entire row command and then click on OK. So the row will be deleted. If you want to delete a column, so place the cursor which you want to place the cursor in a column which you want to delete and then click on the delete column command. I'm going to press Ctrl Z. Okay, if you want to delete the complete table, just apply the delete table command, it will be deleted. I'm going to press Ctrl Z. set command to bring the table back. Next command in rows and column toolbar is insert above, insert below. What will happen if I click on this command insert above? A row will be added in the table where the cursor is pointing. For example, I'm going to add something to make it sure that where the row is going to be added. So I place a cursor in this row and I'm going to apply. Okay, I'm filling this. Now, if I apply the cursor command insert above, what will happen? A row above the cursor will be added in my table. Yes, it is added. If I place a cursor and click the command insert below, so a row will be added below the cursor. If I click on this command insert left, so what will be happened? It will insert a column to the left side of the cursor. Control Z, because I selected three columns, so that's why three columns are inserted on the left side of the cursor. If I click in one cell, means I'm not selecting more than one cell, so it means one column will be inserted in my table. If I select the option left, so it will be inserted at the left side. If I apply the insert right, so a column to the right side of the cursor will be added in my table. Next toolbar is merge. In merge toolbar, we have three commands: merge cells, and split tables. Dear students, merge cell is disabled. If I click on this, no action will be performed. To make it enable, first I have to select the cells, because merge cell is used to convert more than one cells into a single cell. For example, I'm going to convert these three cells into a single cell. Now I will, as I selected these three cells, the merge cell command is enabled. If I click on this, these three cells will be converted into a single cell. So merge cell command is used to convert or to merge, to combine more than one cells into a single cell. The opposite of merge cell is split cell. Split cell command is used to divide a single cell into more than one cells. Let's say I want to divide the single cell into two rows and two columns. So I will place the cursor in the cell where I want to make the split, and then click on the split command. A sub menu appears. In this menu, I will select the number of rows and number of columns in which I want to split the cell. For example, I selected two columns and three rows. Now click on OK. So the single cell will be is converted into two columns and three rows. Dear students, there is another toolbar that is known as cell size. Sizes of the cell can be changed manually or through this menu. For example, if I want to, I'm going to change the size of these cells manually. So I will drag. As I drag, the height of the cell, height of the row is changed. If I want to change the column width, I can do this by dragging the mouse, so the size will be changed. If you want to do this through command, through menu, through toolbar, so go to the height command in the cell toolbar. For example, if I change the value in the cell, in the height option, so the height of the row will be increased. If I am going to change the width of the row, go to the width command and change it. So the width of the column where my cursor was blinking will be changed. Now next command is distribute rows and distribute column. Actually, distribute row command is used to divide the, to bring the all rows in the same width, in the same height. As you can see, height of the first row is changed from the remaining rows. If I want to bring all rows of the same size, I will click this command, distribute rows. So all the rows are distributed with the same height. If I want to change, as you can see that there are columns of different width and you want to bring all columns of the same size, click on the distribute column. So all the columns will be distributed in the same size. Next command is alignment. This command belongs to the text if you want to align the text within the cell. For example, this the entry in this cell, as you can see that the first option is enabled, it means that the entry in the cell is aligned top left. If I want to bring it aligned left but in center, so I will select the second option, align center. So the entry will bring the text in the cell will be aligned left center. If I want to make it align right center, so click this option, the text will be aligned right center. If you want to apply the same command on different cells, so you have to select all the cells. As I have entry in some of the cells, so I will select these cells and I will apply the command. So the command will be applied on each selected cell. Next command is text direction. If you want to change the direction of the text in a cell, just click on this option, direction will be changed. If you click again on this option, direction will be changed, and so keep clicking till you want the desired direction of the cell. Next option is margin. This option is used to increase or decrease the margin of the cell. Margin, as it was told in the lecture, in the first lecture, that margin is a free space. So we have four margins: left, right, top and bottom. If you want to increase the margin size, click on the margin command. You will have four options. If you want to increase the top margin, increase the value and click on OK. As I change the top margin, and now I'm going to click on the OK, so the top margin is changed. If you want to increase the right margin, go to the margin option and select the right margin. Increase the value of the right margin and click on the OK button. So the right margin is increased. So dear student, this was all about layout menu of the table command. Thank you. Have a nice day. Allah Hafiz.